So you want to become better than 99% of programmers, but you're doing the exact same things that 99% of other programmers are already doing. Watching video tutorials, doing online courses, and solving lead code problems. Everybody is doing that. Doing what everyone else is doing is the very definition of how to become average. And there is nothing wrong with that. But if you want to get ahead of others, you have to be willing to do what others are not willing to do. Here are 5 such things you can do right now. Most people think that programmers code all day. In reality, programmers spend a lot of their time debugging code. Breaking things and fixing them is an essential part of becoming a skilled programmer. Yet, beginners don't spend any time trying to learn the right way to debug code. To get started with learning debugging, you can do this course called Software Debugging on Udacity. When I was a beginner, I would watch the longest possible programming tutorial, learn as many languages as I could, and build as many projects as possible. In other words, I thought that quantity is all that matters. But in programming, quality matters much more than quantity. One great project on your resume can easily give you an edge over someone who has 10 basic projects on their resume. Let me ask you a question. During my last 2 years of working at Google, let's assume that I've written a total of 10,000 lines of code. How many total lines of code do you think I've read during the same period? It would easily be 100,000 lines of code. Even though the numbers here are made up, what I'm trying to say is that I would have roughly read 10 times more code than I've written. Yet new programmers spend no time reading code written by experienced programmers. Go to GitHub and spend 30 minutes trying to understand someone else's code every day. The biggest disadvantage that the beginners face is that often they don't get the opportunity to collaborate with the experienced programmers. As a result, they never learn what it's like to work with other engineers on the team. To solve this problem, you can start contributing to open source projects. I will link a guide in the description to help you get started. To become a top 1% programmer, you need to first know what a top 1% programmer looks like. But where can you even find a top 1% programmer? At conferences and meetups. To find meetups happening near you, you can use a website like meetup.com. But before you can do any of this, you need to first know how to think like a programmer. Watch this video for that. My name is Sahil, and I'll see you in the next one.